if you can even call it a zero waste hack. Maybe you just want to call it common sense, also fine with me. Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. My name is Gitte Mary and today, honestly, it's a little bit weird because I haven't been filming a video sitting down talking to a camera for over 2 weeks at this point. This is not even something that you need to know per se because I have had videos planned for you from your perspective. I haven't been missing. And we're going to ease ever so slightly into video creation again. So we're going to do something that's really fun and chill, laid back. I'm gonna look in my little bag and in my big bag and I'm gonna show you what's inside of them. Also, I'm sorry if my voice is a little bit weird. I feel like it's a combo of not having talked to the camera for a long time, but also sleeping outside in a tent for a week. So of course I'm going to show you everything that's in my bag today, some of the items and zero waste swaps you might have seen before, but I also think it's really cool to sort of show you what I bring with me on the daily. Because there's so many different zero waste swaps and reusables and it's sort of unattainable or unrealistic to drag everything with you everywhere. So this is my way of showing you what I choose to prioritize and drag with me everywhere and what I don't necessarily always. Of course, this changes a lot depending on what I need or where I'm going, but this is sort of just, you know, like the basics. Okay, so let's start with the small bag. I either carry like a small handbag like this, or I carry a bigger one, which we will get to. This one is thrifted. I sort of jumped right onto this really small 90s bag trend. First of all, because I think it's super cute. And second of all, because they're really easy to find secondhand. So I had absolutely no trouble finding one of these. And I don't know if people are doing it still. Don't really care either. I really like it. And I feel like this just really completes my outfit, especially because I do like to wear lots of baggy things. And it's nice to have like a tiny small bag to sort of counter out some of the oversizedness of other things. I'm rambling about style. This was not the point of the video. Anywho, let's see what is inside. First of all, there is a teeny tiny canvas bag. I have this in my bag because I'm going to return it to my friend. This isn't even mine. But I think I gave it to her a couple of months back. She brought me bulk sweets yesterday in this bag and she forgot it. So it's in my bag because I'm going to see her so she can have it back. But usually I do carry a tiny canvas bag of sorts in my bag because it's such a handy little thing. It doesn't weigh anything. One second. And I have the bag here. Then I have something that does indeed resemble a plastic bag. And to some extent, it also is. This is one of Molly's poop bags. And yes, I always carry one of those with me. And they're really neat for other things, just not exclusively poop. Because whenever I see trash on the street, or if I see something I really want to pick up, I also put it in this and then I just empty it into a bin later. So I can use these many times for other things than poop. And then its final destination will then be poop. This is not a plastic bag. This is bio-based, made from plant fibers, not petroleum. All the details about bioplastic and the different variations of bioplastic, I have an entire video about that that I will leave down below if you're interested. These ones are from Maystick. It's a Danish brand, so they're really easy to come by. And one of the best alternatives I've seen locally for dog poop. Okay. Then I have some gum. This is a gift. I got a PR sample a while back and now I've sort of put different small boxes of gum in all my bags, so I've always have it on hand. I think that's nice. This is from True Gum. They make vegan and plastic-free gum. Okay, then I have my sunglasses. What do you know? These are super dirty. I cannot see anything. These are a pair of vintage sunglasses that's been restored by Linnell Vintage. Love these. I got them last year for summer, I think. Linnell Vintage is a small local shop that restores vintage sunglasses. I think that's just absolutely amazing rather than, you know, producing new things again and again. And often new things that has like a vintage vibe, then why not just, you know, restore the old things? I really love this mentality. And blue glasses are just the vibe, the entire vibe. Then I have a reusable mask. This one matches my outfit. what do you know? This mask is from Rewinder. I have a couple of different ones from Rewinder and they're really, really comfortable. You're not really required to wear masks in Denmark anymore, really, but I still do wear them, especially in rush hour. Always wear them, and especially if I'm going to the supermarket and lots of other people are there. So I always have them in my bag. If I run into a big crowd or something, then I feel more comfortable, safe. Just because you're not required to do what doesn't mean it's a bad thing to do. Then I have, and this is just actually a plastic thing, but you know, safety first. I have a hand sanitizer. I actually got a big bottle of hand sanitizer and then I just fill it over into this tiny disposable bottle. So it's not disposable anymore. Aha. Then I have, aha, this is a classic. And at this point, I think you've seen it one too many times. Let's keep going, Poopoo. It's the Spork. I have this in my bag constantly because especially now that it's ice cream season, I use it rather than using the small plastic or wooden spoons, and it folds so neatly together, so it's always just really handy to have. And it doesn't take up a lot of room, not even in a small bag. This is from Life Without Plastic, and again, I think I've mentioned it before, but one of my first zero waste swaps. And you know, not broken, half a decade. Just, yeah. Then I have a pencil, stolen like a common thief. This is from the Radisson Hotel. And I think this is from when I went to Hamburg. I think I stayed at a Radisson Hotel there. But I use this for sketching and writing in my notebook and stuff. So my notebook, which is funnily enough, not in here. Then I have my keys. And then I have a power bank with no cord. I went onto one of the local Danish secondhand apps and I just searched for electronic equipment and I found a power bank. I think I got this when I was going to Brussels with the bus, and that's a solid 13-hour bus ride. So I thought, aha, I don't know if there will be an electrical outlet there. So I might as well need a power bank. And since I'm planning on taking the bus and the train lots of places in the future, power bank might be helpful. And if I have the cord too, it also works. Oh, you're just gonna see my trash now as well. I also have a little popsicle stick. I think this is from last week where I got a popsicle and I just couldn't bring myself to throw it away because I know Jens uses these when he builds small miniature houses and stuff. So I just brought this home so he could use that. And also, I sometimes make smoothie popsicles at home with my leftover smoothies. And for that, I also need these. So I just boil it, wash it, put it in a stew. But you can reuse these for all different kinds of small DIY purposes. So I just save it in like this little tiny compartment here. Okay, that was the small bag. Now, the big bag. This one you have seen probably as well if you have watched, well, yeah, any of my videos. This is a Grin Bag shopper that I use like there is no tomorrow. It's made from recycled materials. The handles here are made from seat belts. This is from like an advertisement banner. I love this so much. I don't think they carry this specific model anymore, but I have worked with them this year and I will be working with them again. This is not a video sponsored by them, but this is a sponsored item that I got, I think, 2 or 3 years back. Love this. Firstly, this is the bigger bag, and I use this whenever I go grocery shopping, whenever I know I have to take the train or travel, or whenever I have to go somewhere where I want to carry more things with me, obviously. So first of all, I have my reusable water bottle. I don't bring it when I use my small bag because there's not room for it, unless I just carry it in my hand, which I also sometimes do. But for smaller trips like this, I don't think I need it. But it's an absolute essential if I'm going away from home for a longer period of time. This is also from Rewinder. I think I got this in a PR sample bag that I didn't even ask for. But it was kind of lucky because my clean canteen had just been stolen. So now I use this instead. Reusable water bottle that seals shut, which is, you know, like, kind of essential. Then I have, here's my notebook slash calendar day planner. I plan videos in here, I write my meetings and all other types of plans, I sketch, and I do just basically everything. I also keep up with my like exercise plan. I really like writing tons of stuff in here. Let's see if we can, yeah, like, okay, so I like to write lists and I like to just put in everything that has happened or if something essential or fun a lovely has happened during the week. I also put it in there because then when I filled it out, I sometimes like to take out my old notebooks and day planners and just go through them and check out what was on my mind, what was I thinking about, what was I doing. So this is sort of also like an investment for future Gide, because I do love reading my old calendars. That sounds really sad, but nonetheless, it's a good time. Okay, then I have the book that I'm currently reading. This is Silence of the Girls by Pat Barker. And I am in love with this book. I got some of you on Instagram telling me that there is another version of sort of the same plot that you liked more. But I really, 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 really like this. Also just because I really love Pat Barker and what she's all about. She started writing novels when she was 45 after taking a course in writing with Angela Carter, who wrote The Sardian Woman, which I based the most of my theses on, and I just love it. And this is a book that tells the story of Achilles and Troy, but from women's perspective, and it's really enlightening and a really tough read, because, spoiler alert, history didn't treat women very well.
What else do we have?
Okay, another face mask also matches my outfit. Who would have thunk? Then I have a napkin. And I think I've mentioned this in other videos before, but if I go out to a restaurant, takeout, etc., and they give me napkins, I just save them if I don't need them rather than throwing them away, because I might need them later. This is a very low-effort, zero-waste hack. If you can even call it a zero-waste hack, maybe you just want to call it common sense. Also fine with me. Then I have a straw. These are also gifted to me, not only by companies, also by people in my family and my friends, because they know I'm an environmentalist. So that must mean give her more stainless steel straws. Thank you so much, you guys. Please no more. I feel like I have 20 stainless steel straws at this point. So I've started giving them out again. This one is from Humankind. Let's see. Then I have another True Gum product. This is the True Mint with watermelon flavor.
Okay. What else?
More dental care. So, long story time. Okay, I have had so many issues with my teeth. There's literally no tomorrow. I also recently got one taken out because of nerve damage. So I always carry floss because my teeth are really sensitive. If something gets caught somewhere, I can feel it instantly. An infection will start. I've just been very unlucky when it comes to like my teeth area. It's not amazing. And last time I was in Copenhagen, I didn't bring my floss and I desperately needed it. So I went to a store and I got this plastic-free compostable floss from Jordan. And they're not plastic anywhere in this packaging, which is neat. And this is also, let's see, what is it made out of? Which I, you know, I should know. Thin dental floss made from vegan-friendly materials. Well, that tells me nothing. Unless that we going with the whole plastic is not vegan because it's made from dinosaurs, which is the reasoning. I do distinctively remember the sign saying that it was, you know, compostable, but now I cannot seem to find anything on the packaging itself, only that the packaging is plastic-free. Anyway, I got this as an emergency thing, and now it's my emergency floss that I always have in my bag. It may or may not be zero waste.
What else do we have?
Oh yes, a canvas bag. I've had just rolled this tightly up inside my bag because you don't know if you're gonna see a farmer's market or if you need to buy something in bulk. You don't know what life brings you. So I always carry an extra canvas bag inside my shopper because I have just been in too many situations where I needed it and it wasn't there. So from now on, it's just there. And it has been for quite a while. And I always feel so clever when I'm in a situation I need one or a friend needs one and just pull it out of my bag like, zero waste, woman! The energy. By the way, I forgot I also, of course, also carry different kinds of hair ties, elastic bands, in my bag. I usually find these on the street and then I pop them in the freezer for about 24 hours just to kill potential, you know, head lice, stuff like that. You can also boil them, but there's so many nice hair ties on the street that you can just use. And they're completely free, you know, just clean them properly and you're good to go. And then I have my wallet. This wallet is secondhand. I have my credit card, membership cards, stuff like that. I genuinely try to keep to a minimum, so I only have membership cards and I only accept that kind of stuff if it's super necessary, and I try not to sign up for anything that will give me a card if I won't ever use it because it's plastic and it's also unrecyclable. In my purse, I also have other types of things. I recently found a Pokemon card on the street, so of course that's in there. Then I have some band-aids. These are band-aids from Aid. These are made from bamboo. They're compostable. Love them. And you know, it's just a really nice thing to have. I haven't actually needed a band-aid, but I'm sure the second I take them out of this wallet, I'll need them. So they're just chilling there now. And then I have a couple of receipts. I generally hold on to these also because I'm a business owner. I have to keep track of everything for tax purposes. Receipts are also unrecyclable in Denmark, which is such a shame. They're coated with a thin lining of plastic, which also has BPA in it. Then I have a picture of my mom. Got a little piece of amber. That's everything that's in my bag. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you liked it. Leave me requests down below if there's anything you want to see. I'm sort of again trying to ease myself into a normal work schedule again and getting to record more regularly. I'm working on some bigger impact videos, but I would of course always love to hear if there's anything you're curious about. There's also more vlogs coming, so yeehaw. Thank you so much for watching. Have an amazing day and I will see you guys next time. Take really good care of yourselves. Until then, bye. Thank you so much for watching this video, and also a special thank you to my Patreon supporters. You guys help me create green zero waste content and I love you guys. You can find the links to my social media accounts down below and the link to my Patreon on this screen. Bye!